Hello. Hello.
Can you hear me, Mr. Fuller?
I can hear you.
Okay. This is Gus with the C.O.W.S Radio.
Right.
Am I interrupting you?
No, I have a little while.
Okay. We're live on the program. I was calling have you seen any of the reports about Christopher Dorner, the black male in California, who they suspect shot and killed shot four people, killed three of them?
Christopher who?
Christopher Dorner. He's a black male.
In Los Angeles, right, on the police force, law enforcement.
Right.
I heard a little bit about it. I don't know enough about it really to comment at this point because I just heard about it.
Okay. The first two people that were killed, like he wrote this long letter online, or he's reported to have written this long letter online about having been a victim of racism. Like he says, he was a former LAPD officer, and he said that some of the white officers, they were calling black people niggers, and he physically assaulted them after he told them to stop saying it, and they continued to do so. And he said, you know, I'm going to stand up. I'm a proud black man. I'm not going to let, you know, people disrespect us like that. And he talked about how it was a lot of racism with the LA Police Department. And he was saying that's what he was doing with the issue. At least that's what's been reported online. And I've seen a lot of black people, and they've been saying, yeah, right on. He's fighting against racism and going back and killing these people. But the first two victims in the case, they're both non-white people. And I cannot imagine how that works against racism to attack other non-white people. Does that make any sense to you?
That's why I say I'd have to learn more about it and all like that. And, you know, I'd just say my comments would just be according to what the code says. And, I just go back fundamentally what I put right in front of the book. And that would apply to anybody in any situation that has anything to do with color. If you do not understand white supremacy, you're going to be confused about everything else. And you might wind up doing a whole bunch of stuff that's not going to make sense. In fact, that's a guarantee. You are going to do a whole bunch of stuff that doesn't make sense. And that's all I would have to say about it at this point, simply because I don't know all the details. But from just what you're telling me, I mean, it's not logical. You see what I mean? If there's a race problem, you got to understand a whole lot about that, not a little bit. You got to understand the whole system of racism as far as the basic concept of it and the basic practice of it before you make any moves at all and tell anybody anything. It's a lot of understanding you have to have if you're going to do it in a constructive manner. And apparently, looks like in this particular case, certainly doesn't sound like anything constructive that has happened from what I've heard. So that would be the only comment I'd make at this point based on what you just told me. The way that wound up, I mean, no, that's all messed up. That's messed up from A to Z. That has not produced a constructive result. You have to understand, you know, the system of racism. You're dealing with a system, not just individuals. You're dealing with individuals too, but the individuals are connected with a system. You're always connected with a system. You have to understand something about the system. What it is and how it works. Otherwise, you just get thrown off. Somebody has to get to everybody else who doesn't know and understand something about we are in a system of racism, an entire system, world system, That's where you have to start off every morning looking at it and everything that goes with that. If you don't understand the system of white supremacy, what it is and how it works, everything else that you understand will confuse you. That's not a maybe. You are going to be super confused. And you're going to act like confused people act. And that means multiple errors, one right after another. Because when people are confused, they make errors. One right after another, a whole bunch of them. As long as you're in that confused state. It's unfortunate, but that's the dominant factor in the entire world. Confusion. And the white supremacists love it like that, because they can handle it. Because they are not confused. Not at all. But you'll have to get back to me later on, I mean, you know, when I learn more about it and get the details. But that's what I have to say about it at this point. I mean, whatever the reactions were to whatever those circumstances were, you said two black officers are dead because of it. So that's all messed up, right on that alone. Boom, you know. That's right out of the gate.
They weren't officers. They were civilians. It was a non-white female and a black male. He did shoot two officers as well, but the first two victims before he shot the two officers, these were just civilians. It was reported he's a suspect. They're saying that his motive in shooting these two individuals, the non-white female, she is the daughter of a non-white male who was involved in his case where he was making allegations that some of the other officers had kicked a suspect in the face, where he was dismissed from the L.A. Police Department, and he's saying that this non-white male was involved with that, so he was going to come after him by attacking his daughter. But, yeah, these were just civilians, these non-white
Nobody people. Was supposed to be harmed in any manner except a person who is strongly suspected of being a racist. Anybody else who was harmed, that situation is all messed up. I don't care what the intent is. That intent is dead in the water. That whole scenario is nothing constructive in it at all. Zero. Even if it's all by accident, it's all messed up. These accidents are not supposed to happen. Misunderstanding, whatever it is. If that's the result, hey, according to counter-racist logic, counter-racist science, it's messed up from top to bottom. Nothing constructive came out of that. Just on that alone, it's not supposed to happen. It's another tragedy. Just chalk it up to another junior league tragedy. That's all. Routine. It's another routine. No different from Crips and Bloods. Worth absolutely nothing.
When I would like to speak with you after you've seen more of the details on this. I'm sure they're going to be talking to it because they're still looking for him. He's still on the run.
It's all messed up anyway. On account of just what you told me. I mean, hey, you got somebody other than racist suspects dead? No, absolutely not. That's all messed up. I mean, that's a misunderstanding right there of what racism is all about. Total misunderstanding. Missed the point altogether. When based on what you told me, that, you know, there were some accusations of racism, Well, if it's accusations of racism, why do you have some victims of racism dead? That's all messed up. Only victim of racism is supposed to be dead if there's any kind of action taken and all like that. Depending on what the action was, would be the person who took action against the racist. That's the only person that's supposed to be dead other than the racists themselves, racist suspects. That's it. Nobody else. Nobody else under any circumstance, period. No such thing as collateral damage and all that. No. Doesn't register at all. It's nowhere on the scale. It just winds up being another Crips and Blood type thing. That's all. Okay, how you shake it up and pour it, that's how it comes out. Dead is serious business. Anytime anybody is dead, that should be looked upon as serious business, not routine. In counter-racist science, in racist science, or in racist science, anybody can be dead. I mean, racists love dead bodies, period, stacked to the ceiling. I mean, that's their whole thing. That's enjoyment. Counter-racist science is not about enjoyment of any kind of death-making. It's totally serious. And all of it is supposed to be precision work. It's not supposed to be any oops moments. Or sorry about that. No, doesn't work that way. Everybody involved in anything that has to do with death-making and counter-racist science is supposed to really be razor-sharp in whatever they go about doing if somebody winds up dead. One death is very serious, super serious. Not some type of Vietnamese-type body count. Like you're talking about toothpicks or whatever. That's racist ideology. Oh, well, you know, 200 or 300 people there, you know, a couple of thousand yonder. That's racist ideology. Like when they report it's so-called crime statistics. They'll say, oh, the murder rate is down from what it was a month ago. A month ago it was 400 last month. Now, it was just 380. Are you kidding? And they're talking about the scores are now improved. It's supposed to be zero. What are you talking about? I mean, you talk like somebody who is absolutely insane. You shouldn't even report anything like that. That shouldn't even pass anybody's lips. Some person coming out, you know, sounding all official and whatnot and talking about, oh, we only had, you know, 200 deaths this month. When last month, you know, we had 280. So, boy. You know, we're doing great. That is the height of insanity. To even be thinking like that. Not to say anything about making a report like that. Ever. And I'm talking about something like even traffic deaths. I mean, that thing of just looking at somebody dead like that's nothing. Everybody has gotten in that frame of mind in the system of racism. And that's pitiful. But I'll have to talk to you later about it because I got to go back out.
I definitely appreciate it. I will be in touch after you get some more information on it. I appreciate even that, though, Mr. Fuller.
Okay, well, okay, but hey, that's my frame of reference for it. I mean, you know, that's what I have to say up to this point. And I don't think that's going to change, of course, just on based on what you've told me so far. That's all messed up. All of it, from top to bottom. But, of course, who's to blame? The white supremacists are to blame. Now, I'll say that, too, as a parting note. Because they're always to blame. This is the kind of stuff they engineer. Right from the beginning, they are to blame for all of it. Not some of it, all of it. Because it's in their system. Okay, we'll talk.
Absolutely. Take care, all Mr. Right. Fuller.
Yes, sir. Right.